An American delegation spent part of the week in China talking trade, ending in what both sides called a constructive session. However, the only agreement from the 12th round of discussions was to have more talks in September.
Well, the only way you can read it is it's got to be considered very positive, because if we weren't talking, we'd never get an agreement.
But just hours after U.S. Trade Representative Robert Lighthizer and Treasury Secretary Steven Mnuchin left for home, the president tweeted. Then he met the press.
When my people came home, they said, "We're talking. We have another meeting in early September." I said, "That's fine. But in the meantime, until such time as there's a deal, we'll be taxing them."
His comments were seen as a way of applying pressure to the Chinese with an additional 10% tariff on the remaining $300 billion of Chinese imports beginning September 1. The president has already implemented 25% tariffs on $250 billion in Chinese products, while Beijing has countered by taxing $110 billion on U.S. goods, the majority in the agriculture sector. The latest round could impact more consumer products than previous enactments. The news came just after the White House confirmed China's intent on buying American farm products.
I suspect that if they do purchase agricultural products from the U.S., it's only because they actually need those products, not because they're negotiating in good faith. Now, the Chinese almost never purchase product because out of the goodness of their heart. They do it because they fundamentally need the food. And I think with the devastation that they're currently seeing with their pork industry, they have a need for protein.
Former USDA Secretary and current CEO of the U.S. Dairy Export Council, Tom Vilsack, was on the trade circuit this week, first as a witness in a Senate Finance Committee hearing on the United States-Mexico-Canada agreement. The USMCA still needs to be ratified by the House before it ends up in the Senate.
Surely nobody could consider NAFTA to be better than USMCA, and nobody, let me emphasize, nobody should dismiss the importance of a $500 billion market for U.S. agriculture products.
Vilsack says the administration is anxious to get a win and hopes the pact between the three major trading partners is complete before the end of 2019.
Trade agreements are always hard. They never are won by large margins. So it is important, I think, to get it done as quickly as we possibly can, but to get it done right in a way that people are genuinely satisfied that this is better than NAFTA.
For Market to Market, I'm Paul Yeager.